Joining us this morning on Hits Radio Breakfast is the queen of TV, is the queen of abs, celebrating the brand new series of 100K Drop, a long lost family. It's Davina McCall.
Hi.
How are you doing?
I'm very good, thank you. How are you?
Yeah, great, great. Still recovering from the shots of your abs. I'm not going to lie. We'll get onto that later.
Okay.
But we love 100K Drop. It's so tense though, isn't it?
Well, you know what I love about this show is that it's all about the people, the contestants, and it's like a relationship show. I think I could probably write some kind of book on relationships. I reckon I could suss out in about 3 minutes if a couple are going to stay together after playing this game, because it is the toughest, like most stressful thing I think any couple will ever do.
After 3 minutes of being with us, will you be able to tell us if we're going to stay together as well, Davina?
I can already tell.
Can you tell right now
how are we
doing? Oh, thank you so much.
Absolutely fine.
And because of those relationships, how close, I mean, you must really want to, like if it was a contestants that really, you know, really need the money, you must really want to help them sometimes. I hope you say
yes
to that.
Yeah, but you know the thing, but the thing is that I will stand there and I'll be all smug and I'll go, oh yeah, I know the answer to this one. Yeah, I know this one. And I'm wrong.
Oh.
I know nothing.
Oh, really?
I know nothing because these 100K drop questions are so abstract sometimes. They're really kind of weird questions. And I'll be, I definitely know that, really smug about it. And I'll be completely wrong. So I think, and I often say this to the audience, because sometimes the audience cannot help themselves and they'll move some money, the contestants will move some money and they'll go, and I always think, don't do that because you might be wrong. And then they might make a decision based on a sharp intake of breath that is not a good move.
Fleur,
you know,
is like,
so you've got to be careful with
Fleur
that.
Fleur thinks she's queen of general knowledge. So can you maybe hit us with some of your questions? Do you have a question
now? I can't remember the answer, so this is very unhelpful. But a classic 100K drop question would be, what are there more of, church streets or station roads?
Ooh.
Oh,
that's really
interesting. Do you know what I mean? Like,
I'd say church streets. Can we Google that?
I'd say station roads.
It depends where you are.
Is there a church in every village? And is there a station in every village?
There must
are there
be.
More churches? Well, you'd but, have a church.
It depends on what country or what city you're in.
Like, in the UK.
Oh, in the UK.
Oh, look at you getting all deep.
Yeah, exactly.
Well, it's only because I've just got back from Australia. In Adelaide, in Australia, there's a church and literally more churches than Starbucks because it's the city of churches. That's, I
understand. Is that really true?
Yeah, it's pretty beautiful. Is that right?
Okay. Yes, it is.
How many of them did you visit while you were there?
All the Starbucks. And I occasionally prayed there. Let's see. So I'm going churches. What are you going
kind
for?
I would say station.
Okay.
So yeah, I would.
Okay, we're getting somebody up on Google now.
Get that. So that is what's interesting about the show is that some of them are questions where you have to kind of try and use your common sense.
Can we just pray for the person that's working behind the scenes to work out the answer to that question?
Are they literally like a hamster on a wheel running frantically trying to figure it out?
I tell you what, we're going to come back to this. And right now, let's ask you about the massive show that everybody loves.
Yeah, Long Lost Family is amazing.
Oh my gosh.
Honestly, I really don't cry a lot in life, unless I'm in movies and television. That's when I cry. Mm. And this show is like my weekly appointment to cry. And it's such a nice feeling because you feel sort of hugged on that program. You never cross your legs with sort of fear of something being sensationalist or handled badly. You just know that Long Lost Family are going to sort of deal with a very difficult situation in just the most beautiful way. I love that show. Nikki and I feel so blessed. Our team are extraordinary. It's just the most brilliant program to work on.
Yeah,
we've got some unbelievable stories. We're doing another series for next year. We've just started working on that now.
Wow. Well, I was just going to ask.
Coming in already.
It's interesting because how much time does it actually take to find the long lost family members?
Mm. Sometimes it can take years. I mean, we've had searches that have gone on for years, or sometimes we'll find somebody and they will need 6 months, a year, sometimes 2 years to sit on that information.
Wow.
And then they'll come to us and go, actually, I've changed my mind. I would like to meet up, or I would like to connect. But it's sometimes it's an enormous bombshell.
Has there ever been an occasion when after you've done the big reunited moment that anyone's ever got back in touch and gone, I really wish you hadn't brought them back? You know, when you've had, you know those annoying rallies that stay too long at Christmas? I just worry that that could go wrong.
I mean, it can go very wrong. And one of the huge pieces of advice that, you know, obviously we've got psychologists on hand and they are there for our contributors day and night whenever they want. And that is for their whole life after the show. You know, we've got people that are still talking to people just for bits of advice or guidance on how to handle situations years after they've been reunited.
That's how I would feel.
But actually,
after
you
Christmas
have to go slow. Like the temptation when you meet somebody, especially if it's a very close family member, like a parent or a child, is that you want to rush in and speak to them every day and be with them all the time. And then often it's like it's too much. It's an overkill and it goes too quickly and then something weird happens. So we just say slow it down, keep it very organic, get to know each other very slowly. They're not going to feel like somebody you know really well for a long time because it takes a long time to form a bond, even though they feel very familiar because they look like you or... Mm.
Davina,
yeah,
you're a really pretty crier.
What?
You're like I don't know if I'd be very good on Long Lost Family because I'm quite an ugly crier.
Oh no!
Do you have any advice on how to be a pretty crier?
I mean, I don't know where you've heard I'm a pretty crier.
Well, I've seen you cry.
I've seen you.
What?
We've seen
when?
When I've seen the show.
I don't cry on the show ever.
I think I've seen you cry on the show.
I've never cried on the show.
You've never cried. Why?
Ever. I cry when I'm watching.
You look like you're going to cry.
I sit at home with lots of tissues and I'm snotting all over the place. Oh, I mean, I'm terrible. I'm a car crash of all person.
You have tears in your eyes, though.
The problem is with these shows, like, I can't cry because if a contributor then has to hug me and say, are you okay? That's the worst thing that could possibly
happen. How do you hold it in? Okay, I feel like I need that in life because I can't stop myself
from crying. Thumb.
Pinch your thumb?
I push my thumbnail into my first finger, my forefinger. Until I hurt myself.
Oh my God.
Wow.
To not cry.
Oh my God.
Yeah. Honestly, it's really hard.
You're a very strong woman, Davina. I need to touch on this because I can't talk to you without talking about this. Your abs are just out of this world. It's just your body. You are literally body inspiration for me. Can we talk a bit about your fitness? So what is going on here? Like, how often are you training? What is the discipline? Please just talk to me.
I was just showing my abs to the camera.
Love it.
So, do you know what? Abs are a little bit of genetics because there are different shapes of bodies.
Yeah.
And for example, I have two daughters and they have completely different physiques. And one has literally twiglet legs that go on for miles. And she's more of an apple shape. So, and the other one is like an hourglass, tiny waist, larger bottom. Bit more like me, really, sort of just...
She got a body just, like an hourglass.
Yes, like that. That's exactly it. And so they're always arguing over who's got the best deal, you know, like Tilly always wants the long willowy legs and Holly always wants the flat tummy. And so I think it is slightly genetic. But I will never have legs like Holly. Like, I would love to have really skinny legs, but that is not my body shape. So you have to work out to your body shape and you have to accept who you are. And I think as you get older, you get better at doing that. But I'm just lucky because I've got a generally flat tummy. So it doesn't take a huge amount of work. But I do a lot of core work. I do a lot of bar work. Yoga.
Do you eat carbs?
We have to eat carbs because that's where we get energy from.
We do.
You know, we need carbs, protein, we need fat. We just need to eat the right amounts of it. Like, I don't carb up for breakfast, lunch and dinner.
Davina, finally, we'd like to ask you one more thing. There's been something we've been talking about this morning, which we've been calling lame revenge. When you get your own back in somebody, just in a tiny little way, like, for instance...
I've got a good one.
Yeah, great. Go. I thought you would.
Okay, so I was at my local train station and I had my AirPods in and I just paid for my ticket and the guy behind the screen, I tapped my ear and I took a phone call and I was paying on the credit card thing outside the window. And I was like, oh, hi, how are you doing? Paid for that. And then I sort of looked at the guy and I went, thank you. And he went, so rude to me.
Oh.
And I was like, sorry. And he went, that's so rude. Take your call while I'm selling you a ticket. And I was like,
whoa.
Oh, I'm really sorry. Like, and he went, have a nice day. Not.
Wow.
So oh my God. I was like, ooh, ow. And I walked away and I thought, I felt like I'd been stabbed in the heart. I was like, oh God, that really hurt. And I went to London and I arrived at Charing Cross and I went straight to the card shop and I bought a little card with like a puppy dog on it. And then on the way back home, I wrote in the card, I went, dear man behind the glass.
No.
I am the girl that was on her AirPods that took a phone call from somebody that I don't see very often and who I love very much. And I was really happy to hear from them. And I did take that phone call. But I'm really sorry that made you feel angry, which it clearly did because you said, have a nice day, not. And I said, but rather than getting angry with you, I actually feel like you need a hug. So here I am giving you a big hug. Lots of love, Davina.
Yes.
And I went and I delivered it to him and went, there you go. I just thought you might be having a bad day.
That is both savage and so beautiful.
That was sort of savage and kind all at the same time.
Yes.
It's perfect. That is literally a perfect lame revenge. Yeah. I think we should all carry cards for that
kill
reason.
Kill them with kindness.
Kill them with kindness. That is the best revenge of all because it's the revenge they're not expecting.
Exactly. Love it.
Surprise.
Davina, thank you so much for joining us this morning and we look forward to more 100K and Long Lost Family. Thank you, Davina McCall.
Say you love us back. Tell us you love us back.
I said I love you. Jesus, okay. You're so needy.
What, do you want a card? Do you want a card?
I want a card.
Send him a card, Davina.
Send me a card.
Thanks, Davina.
Wake up. Radio Breakfast with Fleur East, Greg and James. It's great.